Hello everyone and welcome back to the beautiful studio here at Felix Smart in Calgary, Alberta, Canada. Today we're going to be talking about the three different types of filtration. Now, with filtration, there's often many different ways that you can think about them, but the three main types of filtration that we have are chemical filtration, mechanical filtration, and biological filtration. And today we're going to be discussing a little bit about each one. Now, the first type of filtration that we're going to discuss is chemical filtration. Now, chemical filtration is the additive of a chemical to reduce or trap the waste in your aquarium. There are various different types of chemical filtration, but one of the most commonly used is activated charcoal or carbon. Now, activated carbon will actually help reduce organics in the water and also remove kind of the brown tint that you can sometimes get from wood by trapping those organics into the material itself. You can also use liquid additives in a pinch if you need it. For example, some will help you reduce ammonia if you happen to have an ammonia spike. Now, the advantages of chemical filtration is that they can be used immediately with visible results. For example, as you use activated charcoal or carbon, you will actually slowly over time start seeing the brownness of your water disappear. So you can visibly see that the material is actually working. Another advantage is that this stuff is generally readily available at almost all pet stores. I have even seen some of the additives that you can use in grocery stores as well. Now, there are some disadvantages to chemical filtration also. One of the main ones is that it needs replacement. So activated carbon will lose its efficiency over time and will need to be replaced fully. So if you start seeing the brownness of your water start to come back, that's a good sign that the activated carbon is no longer working. Another bigger disadvantage to chemical filtration is that it doesn't solve the underlying issue or the cause for why you're using it. So while activated carbon can help trap that brown looking particles in your water, it's not gonna prevent whatever is releasing those brown particles into your water. So ideally you still want to figure out why you're actually using chemical filtration to see if you can pinpoint the problem itself. The nice thing is though, again, it's readily available, you can see it working, and you can use it in a pinch if you need it. Now, the second type of filtration we'll discuss is mechanical filtration. Now, mechanical filtration is the use of a screen or item to physically remove particles of waste from the water column. Two of the most popular examples of this are filter floss or filter sponge. Now, these are often placed inside of your aquarium, whether it's a canister filter, hang on back, internal, it really doesn't matter. These are placed inside and water is forced to go through them, trapping the particles of waste in the sponge or floss itself. Now, two main advantages of these types of media is that they are super easy to replace and pretty much available at any pet store. So you should have no issues finding this. Another advantage of this is that you can actually see these items working. So as particles are being trapped in the sponge or floss, it will actually change the color of it depending on what it is trapping. And when you can start seeing it getting thick and mucky, you can actually remove it, clean it, and place it back in, or over time, just replace the sponge altogether. There are a couple of disadvantages to mechanical filtration, and one of them is that they can fail if you do not maintain them regularly. So as the sponge, for example, is trapping waste organics, it can actually become oversaturated, and if you do not remove it and clean it, you're actually contributing because at one point it can't trap anymore and it'll start to decay, and those wastes will go back into your water column. The other issue with mechanical filtration as well is that it doesn't actually remove any chemical imbalances of your water. So if you do have an ammonia spike, a sponge is not going to fix that problem. However, these work best in conjunction with the other two types, which we'll discuss the last one in a minute here. Now, biological filtration is the last one we'll discuss today, and biological filtration is essentially using beneficial bacteria to clean water at a molecular level. The thing with that beneficial bacteria is that it needs a place to colonize. So while you can buy the bacteria in a bottle to use in your aquarium, you also do need media in your aquarium to give it a place to call itself a home. Now, a lot of places will sell you ceramic rings, or you can even use crushed lava rock as an option as well. Once the bacteria colonizes these areas, it'll begin to spread throughout your aquarium, and then that bacteria will start pulling ammonia or other chemicals such as nitrite and turn it into something that can be used for your plants to actually consume as an energy source. Now, the advantages of biological filtration is that it does purify your water altogether. So unlike the other two methods, which either sometimes just trap organics or particles, biological filtration will actually clear your water altogether. Another advantage is that it's technically free. While you can get bacteria in a bottle to use, if you allow your tank to sit for a certain amount of time, bacteria will automatically start to colonize it. And there's lots of information out there on how to actually do that. But with a little bit of patience, you can actually create quite a great colony of beneficial bacteria in an aquarium without any added costs. There are a couple of disadvantages to beneficial bacteria, and one of them, which we just discussed, is that it does require patience. Meaning that if you're not adding an additive, or even if you are adding an additive, you still need to wait a certain amount of time for the bacteria to colonize and therefore start cleaning the water itself. Another disadvantage is that you can't see it. I mean, you could get a microscope and technically look at the bacteria, but overall you can't see it working. So you either need like a test kit to actually measure whether certain chemicals are actually reducing over time, or you just need to be patient and assume that it is working as well, which is why giving it some time to take place and colonize is important. Obviously, patience is not something that can be easily done if you really want to get fish into your aquarium. So having bacteria in a bottle can speed up that process. Now, the question is, which of these methods is best? And that often gets asked by new aquarium hobbyists. And really, it just depends on your situation. There are times where you might need to add a quick fix if you need to reduce ammonia in your aquarium. Also, there might be times where mechanical filtration will be enough for you if you have a really small filter, because bacteria will colonize in these sponges. But ideally, what we recommend is that you focus on a strong biological filtration system, meaning you allow your aquarium to colonize this bacteria, and then you support it with mechanical filtration, and then use chemical filtration as needed when you're in a pinch. We hope that this introduction to the different types of filtration has been helpful today. And as always, don't hesitate to write a comment below of perhaps what you think about filtration and maybe which ones you prefer to have most in your aquarium. And as always, don't forget to like and follow, and we will see you on the next one. Bye-bye.